because of my interest. 2 days back, I just installed Warrior ROM in my Motorola Moto E 1st Gen. Don't panic, it's unofficial build from AOSCP, which stands for Android Open Source Cyber Project. This ROM gives the exact pure Android taste what you will get on Google phones like Pixel. In my experience, it's cool. Of course, some problems are there. However, in this video, we will take an in-depth look on it. And welcome to the 4th episode of In-Depth Look. To get the clear picture of this video, just turn on the subtitle so you can get exact what I am trying to tell. Firstly, I want to tell this. In Oreo 8.0, if you click the camera, it opens the browser. I'm just kidding. The browser icon looks like a camera. It made me weird at first. Now we see specification of this device. It has 1 GB of RAM, 1.2 GHz of Snapdragon 410 processor. You might think that it's really low specification, but it's working with zero lags. The performance was in flow and animations are smooth. That's what about the performance side. So most of the devices are eligible to get Oreo, but the development. And now we see something about CyberOS. Basically, it made for to get the pure feel of Android. It doesn't have any extra bloatwares and UI modification. Looks pure stock Android feel. Even it doesn't have any features what Lineage or Aura ROM has. It's aroma feel. Here I not yet installed G apps because the installation of G apps making some problem and issues in this unofficial build. So I leaved it. The camera is not working. Yes, it's in development. Also, it has the footage camera, but that also, I know, it's in development. Auto rotation not working, memory slot not working, FM radio is not there. Even there is no sound record. I know, it is in development. But I have to tell one thing here. As you know, the Oreo has the 3D touch feature. While I am clicking on the footage camera, it shows selfie camera option. Any hidden front camera is there on Moto E 1st Gen? I know, it's in development. Let's change the topic. The boot animation was really cool. It's like a Pixel boot up animation. The Octopus activity was really wonderful. To track the Octopus, you have to drag from the head. The navbar wise, it comes originally Pixel navbar. That was mentionable. Basically, the custom ROMs comes with two default launcher. They are TubeChat and Pixel launcher. But here it only has the Pixel launcher alone. The simple and fantastic one. The setting wise, it does not have any improvement, but it made some modifications. The UI was full and fully moved to material white, and all the icons and text are gray, the top combination. And in some settings, you have the basic and frequent things in front. By clicking more option, you can get all the advanced things. The status bar wise, it is same like a nugget, but the fully white and gray finished. Also, you have the pull down key and things in the bottom of the status bar, unlike Nougat. The battery performance wise, it's not bad, but while comparing to the Nougat 7.1, it's really poor one. I know it's in development and it has some interface modification. The calling interface is changed little bit and it is transparent. That was impressive. So that is what the thing. In my opinion, the Android R versions comes with some major improvement like Lollipop and Nougat. Oreo is not exception on that. Only some minor changes are there, like the improvement from Lollipop to Marshmallow. The conclusion is this unofficial build is not suitable for daily drive for me. And it's same like Nougat, there is no big improvement. And this is CyberOS version 5.0 funnel cake. So if you want to taste the Oreo unofficially, I give the link of it. Download and try it your own risk. But it's just for the taste, not for entire day-to-day work. So that's it for this video, and give the thumbs up if you like this video and to encourage me by subscribing to this channel. Here, Stark signing off, and I will see you in the next good one. Code Motor.